Corporate directors or officers are often presented with outside business opportunities. In Guth versus Loft Incorporated, we explore whether it's permissible for them to take advantage of such opportunities to further their own interests. Loft Incorporated was a manufacturer and retailer of candies, beverages, and food. It manufactured most of the syrups it needed for fountain drink sales in its many stores, but purchased its cola syrup from the Coca-Cola Company. In 1931, Charles Guth, Loft's president and dominant director, became unhappy that Loft was paying almost full price for Coca-Cola syrup when smaller wholesale customers were paying less. He suggested replacing the cola syrup in Loft stores with Pepsi-Cola, a syrup manufactured by National Pepsi-Cola Company. Almost simultaneously, National Pepsi-Cola Company went bankrupt. Guth and another purchased the Pepsi-Cola formula and trademark from the trustee in bankruptcy and formed Pepsi-Cola Company, which we'll refer to as Pepsi. Guth acquired his interest in Pepsi in his own name and via his family's corporation, Grace Company, Incorporated. But over the next few years, he used Loft's manufacturing facilities, credit, materials, and employees to further Pepsi business without the knowledge of Loft's board of directors. And as Loft's president, he replaced Coca-Cola with Pepsi-Cola in Loft's stores, making Loft a substantial Pepsi customer. Loft subsequently sued Guth, Grace Company, and Pepsi, alleging that Guth breached his duty of loyalty to Loft by usurping a corporate opportunity, namely the opportunity for Loft to purchase the Pepsi-Cola formula, trademark, and goodwill. Delaware's Chancery Court held in favor of Loft and ordered Guth and Grace Company to transfer their Pepsi stock to Loft as an equitable remedy. Guth, Grace Company, and Pepsi appealed to the Delaware Supreme Court.